The members of the Hampstead Folk Club enjoy a rather different sort of music. The club, which meets every Sunday night in a room over a pub, has been going for 9 months. And it's typical of at least 200 other similar clubs which have been mushrooming up all over the country. 500 members pay an annual subscription of 2 bob, and there's an average weekly attendance of about 100. Entrance fee, 4 bob for members, 5 for non-members, and profits to the local hospital. The secretary of the club is Don Wallace, a chartered accountant.
The first night we opened, it was a wet night, lots of rain, and had about 150 people there, packed out. And this interest has continued ever since. I think it's because sort of people in this area, young people especially, like coming along and singing, not just being a sort of passive receiver of what's given to them, but joining in.
At the Hampstead Club, singers are encouraged to get up from the floor and, as it were, cut their teeth, though Terry Gould is, in fact, one of the founder members of the club.
Thank you very much.
Yes, lovely.
Thank you very much. I'd like to sing you a little French love song that I discovered and I hope you'll like. Cette sauce de haute qualité est un mélange de fruits orientaux, d'épices et de vinaigre de malt.
Terry Gould runs a coffee, tea and honey shop in Hampstead, which he started on a £400 gratuity from the Air Force. He's 31 now and unmarried. He first started playing the guitar when he was 19 at Southampton University, where incidentally he got a degree in economics. He played classical guitar music for a while and then took up folk singing again when the Hampstead Club was formed. The rest of his family is quite unmusical. Like many singers on the folk scene today, he composes much of his own material, mainly comment on the contemporary scene. This romantic French love song is in fact not a love song at all, but the instructions in French on a bottle of sauce.
Potage et le pudding. Birmingham, Angleterre.
But for its high attendance figures, the club relies on professionals like Isla Cameron.
Don't sing sad songs, you'll wake my mother. She's sleeping here, close by my side. And in her right hand, a silver dagger. She knows that I won't be your bride. All men are false, says my mother. They tell you wicked love and lies. The very next evening they are caught another. Leave you alone to pine and sigh.
I don't want to sound like the high priestess of English folk music, but it's been going on in England for some time. A good 10 years, but it's not as popular as it is now. And the nice thing about now is that everybody's singing. Before, there were just a few of us, you know, Ewan McCall and Seamus Ennis and A.L. Lloyd and myself. And we did these rather esoteric programs on the third program about St. Cecilia and the Shovel, I think one was called. And they were all right, we used traditional music, but it wasn't as alive as it is now. And the nice thing about now is that everybody sings, because you know, singing's an expression of joy, and I'm all for people being happy.
This pair, who don't usually work together, are a different kind of professional, sort of itinerant troubadours. They're full-time folk singers. They both have had a variety of jobs before coming to it. Oh, Mary, don't you read? Oh. Sullivan on the left started life as a messenger boy at Broadcasting House and later was a merchant navy farmer. Martin Windsor claims to have been entertaining since the age of four, a singer, cabaret artist, impersonator and fire eater. He's 40 now, twice married and divorced, and already a grandfather.
First mate, he got drunk, broke up the people drunk.
The whole point about this pair is that they'll sing anywhere, anytime, that they can find an audience to listen to them and pay them. On this occasion, lunchtime workers at Tower Hill. Folk singing is in essence an amateur activity, and its mecca is Cecil Sharp House in London, dedicated to a man who rescued much folk music from oblivion, but at the cost, some say, of purification of the more earthy lyrics.
Right, in the chord of C, ballad lick or arpeggio, we're going to start I Never Will Marry. Just follow me to start with.
Altogether, there are five classes going on here at the same time. This is the second stage class. Students pay half a crown for as many lessons as they want. Learning to play the guitar well takes at least a year.
And it sounded so lonely in the waters nearby.
The demand for folk guitars, round hole guitars we call them in the trade, has grown to such proportions that we hardly know where to turn. Their price field starts at about 8 guineas and runs as high as 215 guineas. I don't know where it's going to end.
Michael rode aboard a shark. Michael rode.
Pete Seeger is, as it were, the Toscanini of the folk singing world. And the present revival in folk music is probably as much due to him as anyone. He's an extraordinary man, humble, almost unaware of his fame, yet made of steel, utterly uncompromising. He stopped off in London recently on his way back from a world tour, and members of folk clubs from all over the country came to hear him.
Most people, most musicians, travel in a fairly restricted area around their own country to people that know their kind of music. But I think it's worth remembering that in the Middle Ages, musicians were always crossing language barriers. How do you suppose it is that some of these melodies that you and I know are also known in Finland and Russia and Italy? That little tune, da 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 da, is known in every single country of Europe. Absolutely. Some in Norway, ole ole Anna, ole ole Anna, ole 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 Anna. And in Sweden, pum 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 pum. In the Ukraine, diddling 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 diddling. And in Israel, you know that pentatonic minor which is only known in Japan, I believe? Da 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 da. If you hear a song in that right away, you see Japan in your mind's eye.
Dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee.
Same thing in Japan, I found people trying to play Tennessee Mountain style fiddling. They'd heard the Grand Ole Opry on shortwave radio and decided that was the thing for them. They now have in Tokyo a thing called the Tokyo Grand Ole Opry.
I'll do a little bit of colours then, huh?
Yeah, please, that'd be great.
Okay, tell me when. Like I was telling you about Daryl Adams, when I wrote Colors, I was kind of transposing a banjo style to guitar, just like the Carter family had transposed the style from banjo to guitar. And I actually played banjo on Colors. I played the banjo in Daryl Adams' style. So this was the second single. Yellow is the color of my true love's hair. In the morning, when we rise, in the morning, when we rise, that's the time I love the best. Blue is the color of the sky, in the morning. In the morning, when we rise, that's the time, that's the time I love the best. Freedom is a word I really use without thinking. Without thinking, of the time, when I've been low. Yellow is the color of my true love's hair in the morning when we rise. In the morning. When we rise, that's the time, I love the best. Train's in the station now.
They make beautiful music. All the songs they sing, they wrote themselves. They're Robin and Mike, the incredible string band.
When Gimmel and Darlath were standing between, and out of the evening was growing a veil that pined for the pine woods and ached for the sail. There's something forgotten, I want you to know. The freckles of rain, they are telling me so. Oh, it's the half remarkable question. What is it that we are part of? And what is it that we are. Elephant madness has covered the sun, and the judge and the juries still play for the fun. They've torn all the roses, washed all the soap, and the martyr who marries them dares not elope. Oh, it's the never realized question. What is it that we are part of? And what is it that we are? Oh, long, oh, long ere yet my eyes braved the gates in and its bigness, the breath and its gasp, the mind and its motion, the foot and its move, the life and its pattern, the heart and its love. Oh, it's the old forgotten question. What is it that we are part of? What is it that we are?
never sat upon, spat upon, ride it on. Oh Lord, why have you forsaken me?
Judith Pierpi was born 46 years ago in Germany. A Jew by race, though never by religion, she was brought up as an atheist. Her mother committed suicide when she was 3, and when she was 13, her father fled from the Nazis. She was arrested as a hostage, taken to Berlin Gestapo headquarters, imprisoned and tortured. 3 months later, she was released and subsequently escaped from Germany. For several years, she wandered through Europe, stateless, homeless, and destitute. Just before the war, she came to England, and in 1946, she became a Christian.
Just like anything, to sing, to sing, to sing, is a state of mind.
The young people I know in the folk clubs of Soho don't go to church much, and I doubt if they watch Meeting Point. They don't much go on organized religion, but they do go on songs like these. Songs that express what many of them feel, songs that arise out of the situation in which I work. This one, by Jackson Frank, just explains why people sing. But some of the songs that I want you to hear are not particularly pretty, nor are they intended to be. But they are true. And the truth sets us free. The troubadours of the Middle Ages sang to win the love of a lady. These troubadours of the 1960s sing to win your love for the unloved, the despised, the rejected. The outsider speaks for the outcast who cannot speak for himself. Listen to them.
Born in England's pleasant green, like a picture postcard scene, to childhood spread with fond maternal care. From the day that he was born, proud relations came to form and compliment his pretty golden hair. In boyhood sent away to a boarding school to stay, its crumbling proud traditions forced to bear. And his friends in this new world said he looks more like a girl with those blue eyes and pretty golden hair. From safe, secluded youth into manhood's search for truth, his mother's eyes now wet and turned to stare. For he said, I must be bound this day for London town. Oh, I do believe my fortune's waiting there. So like an eager cutting knife, he plunged in a new life, oh, never known beforehand anywhere. And the thought that he might trip in his ignorance and slip never struck beneath his pretty golden hair. But the days soon grew thin, and boredom fast set in. His job was thrown away without a care. For a man subtly said, you'll earn twice as much instead with those blue eyes and pretty golden hair. For a London town possessed, oh, many a tempter's nest, and thus he fell with scarce a thought or care. And so easily he slipped into prostitution's grip, foundationed by his pretty golden hair. Then the years quickly flew, and his mind slowly grew from early freedom into deep despair. As the money ceased to roll, a tired and lonely soul poured curses on his pretty golden hair. Oh, the years stole their time, now the living's hard to find, and early friends have vanished in the air. And the gay party's ease changed to public lavatories have turned to grey his pretty golden hair. Oh, his life was only used and his body just abused by those who never think and never care. If his file said suicide, no, that wasn't why he died. It was murder by his pretty golden.
Sadness fills your heart, and sorrow hides the longing to be free. When things go wrong each day, you fix your mind to escape your misery. Your troubled young life had made you turn to a needle of death. How strange your happy words have ceased to bring a smile from everyone. How tears have filled the eyes of friends that you once had walked among. Your troubled young life had made you turn to a needle of death. Grain of pure white snow dissolved in blood spread quickly to your brain. In peace your mind withdraws, yet death so near your soul can feel no pain. Your troubled young life had made you turn to a needle of death. Man's desires to free his mind, to release his very soul, has proved to all who live that death itself is freedom forevermore. And your troubled young life will make you turn to a needle of death.
Day in a deep and dark December, I am alone, gazing from my window to the streets below on a freshly fallen silent shroud of snow. I am a rock, I am an fortress deep and mighty that none may penetrate. I have no need of friendship. Friendship causes pain. It's laughter and it's love and I disdain. I am a rock, I am an island. Don't talk of love, I've heard the it's sleeping in my memory. I won't disturb the slumber of feelings that have died. If a never lover never would have cried. I am a rock, I am an island. I have my books and my poetry to protect me. I'm shielded by my armor. I'm hiding in my room, safe within my womb. I touch no one and no one touches me. I am a rock, I am an island, and a rock can feel no pain.
say you were victorious over hell and over death. We know the hell of heroin, the dying that is meth. So come down, Lord, from your heaven, you whom we can't confess, and be the resurrection of this our living death.
Thrown like a star in my vast sleep, I opened my eyes to take a peep, to find that I was by the sea, gazing with tranquility. Just then when I heard a hurdy-gurdy man come singing songs of love, then when I heard a hurdy-gurdy man come singing songs of love. Histories of ages past, unenlightened shadows cast down through all eternity, the crying of humanity. 'Tis then when the hurdy-gurdy man comes singing songs of love. Then when the hurdy-gurdy man comes singing songs of love. Hurdy-gurdy, here comes a roly-poly man and he's singing songs of love. Roly-poly, roly-poly, roly-roly-poly, he's singing. Hurdy-gurdy, hurdy-gurdy, hurdy-gurdy-gurdy, he's singing. Hurdy-gurdy, hurdy-gurdy, hurdy-gurdy-gurdy.
Ready?
Phil?
Yep.
Two?
Okay.
I'll give you a cue.
When you're not.
In your own time.
Adieu, adieu, hard was my fate. I was brought up in a tender state. But company, it didn't me entice. I left off work and took bad advice, which makes me now to lament and say, pity the fates of young fans all. Oh, well, oh, day, well, oh, day. I robbed Lord Gold when I do declare, shut the shutters and bid them good night, and then went home to my heart. say, pity the fate of young felons I was took before Judge Aldred. I was tried. My Lady Camp says this will not do. My iron chest you have broken through, which makes me now a two-loved man. And say, pity the fates of young felons are. Costly tombstone will I crave. Six bonny lassies to carry my pall. Give them broadswords, cups, and ribbons all. Which makes me now to lament and say, pity the fates of young felons all. Oh,
in a sleazy snack bar, sucking sickly sausage rolls, slipping down slowly, slipping down sideways, think I'll sign off the door.
Cause the fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine.
Could a copper catch a crooked coffin maker? Could a copper comprehend that a crooked coffin maker's just an undertaker who undertakes to be a friend?
And the fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine.
tell the truth tomorrow. Today may take its time to tell you what tonight might bring. Presently we'll have a pint or two together. Everybody do their thing. Swing together, we can have a wee-wee. We can have a wet on the wall. If someone slips a whisper that it's sinful, sister, slap them down and slap it on their smalls. Cause the fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. The fog on the tine is all mine. Fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. Fog on the tine is all mine. Fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. Fog on the tine is all mine. Fog on the tine is all mine, all mine. Fog on the tine is all
on one bright March morning, I bid New Orleans adieu. And I took the road to Jacksonville, a fortune to renew. I coursed all foreign money, no credit could I gain, which filled me heart with longing for the lakes of Pontchartrain. Well, I stepped on board of a railroad car beneath the morning sun. I rode the rods till evening, and I laid me down again. All strangers there, no friends to me, till a dark girl towards me came. And I fell in love with a Creole girl by the lakes of Pontchartrain. I said, me pretty Creole girl, my money here's no good. And if it weren't for the alligators, I'd sleep out in the wood. You're welcome here, kind stranger, our house is very plain. Never turn a stranger out on the banks of Pontchartrain.
me into her mommy's house, and she treated me right well. The hair upon her shoulders and the jet black ringlets fell to try to paint her beauty. I'm sure 'twould be in vain. So handsome was my Creole girl by the lakes of Pontchartrain. Well, I asked her if she'd marry me. She said this could never be, for she had got a lover, far at sea. She said that she would wait for him, and true, she would remain till he'd return to his Creole girl by the lakes of Pontchartrain. Fare thee well, my bonnie own girl, I never may see you more. But I'll never forget your kindness in the cottage by the shore. And at each social gathering, a flowing glass I'll drink. And I'll drink a health to me Creole girl by the lakes of Pontchartrain.
Well, you know how to play cracker ball? What? Oh, we'll have to show you. You'll see, it's a nice football game. It's a marvellous game, this. But for a moment, we're going to take a break with some lovely music, and let's welcome to the programme, Steel Eye Span.
I will wear the green willow and all around my hat for a 12-month and a day. And if anyone should ask me the reason why I'm wearing it, it's all for my true love, who's far, far away.
The night he brought me
the day. And if anyone should ask me the reason why I'm wearing it, it's all for my true love, who's far, far away. All around my hat I will wear the green willow, and all around my hat for a 12-month and a day. And if anyone should ask me the reason why I'm wearing it, it's all for my true love, who's far, far away.
There came three men from out of the west, their fortune for to try. And these three men made a solemn vow John Barleycorn should die. They knocked him down, they harrowed him in, laid clods upon his head. And these three men made a solemn vow John Barleycorn is dead. My mother was half English, and I'm half English too. I'm a great big bundle of culture tied up in the red, white and blue. I'm a fine example of your Essex man. I'm well familiar with the Hindustan, 'cause my neighbours are half English and I'm half English too. My breakfast was half English, and so am I, you know. Got a plate of Marmite soldiers washed down with a cappuccino. And I have a veggie curry about once a week. The next day I fry it up as bubble and squeak, 'cause my appetite's half English and I'm half English. Britannia, she's half English, she speaks Latin at home. And St. George was born in the Lebanon. How he got here, I don't know. And those three lions on your shirt, they never sprung from England's dirt. Them lions are half English and I'm half English too. And I'm half English too.
Excellent. Brilliant.
All right?
Yeah, fine.
Cool.